Hello friends, this is Durga from ITversity. Before we get started, let me share this link in some forums so that people can join. And then I will actually walk you through about the agenda and I will take it further. Okay, so just give me a moment. So before getting into the stuff, let me share my screen. Also, let me actually share it on YouTube and then I'll take it further. Sorry, not YouTube, but the LinkedIn. So I'm using Zoom. So I just started the webinar and then started the YouTube streaming. It's an impromptu session. I just want to get some traction by sharing on the LinkedIn and then we will take it further. So please be patient for a minute or so. We will get into the agenda. For some reason there is issue. Just give me a moment. We'll get started. Yeah. So before getting into the session, first let me define the problem statement and we'll take it further. So I'm going to use labs.itversity.com or the cluster supported by labs.itversity.com, which you can actually purchase the subscription and get the similar kind of support, which one of my students have asked for in the past. Once you sign up for the labs, you also get access to Slack channel and you can ask questions in the Slack. And if required, I will get into your Jupyter notebooks and I will solve the problem. So I'm actually walking you through that life cycle of the support where I have solved some complex problems within no time, where the student was struggling for a few days to get the solution for. There are a few issues as per his or her thought process due to which he or she have to spend time on it. And once I chip in, once I understood the problem, within half an hour, she got the solution. And the same level of support you also might get once you sign up for the labs and be part of the Slack channel. So let me define the problem statement and I'll take it further. Here, once you sign up for our labs, you will get access to something called as Jupyter Notebooks. Okay, so now I'm sharing my browser. Let me log out from this user. And let me log in using my user. So I'm using my username to log in. Meanwhile, let me also reproduce the issue for you so that I can actually walk you through the solution. So just give me a moment before I reproduce the issue. So I copied the file using which that subscriber was struggling with. Now I will actually walk you through the problem. So this is the file diamonds.csv, which is there on gw03.itversity.com. And she's trying to create the data frame, or he or she is trying to create the data frame to actually perform some of the exercises for the learning purpose of the student. Okay. So first, let me walk you through where the confusion was created in her or his mind, and how I helped to overcome that confusion. And I'm creating this video to clear some of the concepts so that the things are clear for everyone, not only for that student who raised the issue as part of the support process. So in this case, if you want to launch Linux-based terminal, once you get access to the labs and once you get into the Jupyter notebook, you can go to new terminal, and then you should be able to access the terminal. So when it comes to running Spark jobs, we can run Spark jobs in multiple modes. What are those modes? For that, I'm taking you to the official documentation of Spark. Okay, and as part of the official documentation of Spark, if you go to latest release documentation, if you go to deploying, these are the four execution modes in which we can submit our Spark jobs, and these four are cluster modes. On top of these four, there is also something called as local mode. Okay, you also need to understand this picture to get into the details about how the jobs will be run in local mode and cluster mode. So in this case, I'll be using Yarn for the cluster mode, and also I will demonstrate the actual problem in a moment. Then I will actually get into the solution. So here, when we launch PySpark like this, in this case, I want to launch PySpark with Python 3. By default, it will be launched with Python 2. We might change this behavior very soon, but for now, if you want to launch PySpark with Python 3, you have to set this variable called as PySpark Python equal to Python 3. And then you can say PySpark 2 to launch Spark context with Spark 2. So you will see the version of Spark very soon. It is nothing but Spark 2.3.0. Okay. Yeah, you can see this is the Spark version, and the Python version is this one. Now, if I say df equal to spark.read.csv, and if I say /home/training, diamonds.csv, in the local mode, it will work without any issues. Okay, I have to specify file like this, file colon, and hit enter. Because our Spark and Hadoop are integrated, even when we are trying to run using local mode, it will try to look for the file in HDFS. But this file is not available in HDFS, that's why it is failing. Now by saying file colon, it is trying to get the file from the local file system. Okay, now I can say df.show, and I should be able to see the data. If I want to provide the header and also infer the data types of these columns, I can say comma header equal to true and infer schema equal to true. Let me get into the next line. So header equal to true, and then infer schema equal to true, and hit enter. Now we can say df.print schema to get the schema details, and also df.show to see the data, to preview the data. So as the file and the Spark context are running, file is local and the Spark context is also running locally. As we are running in local mode, we are able to read the file on the server, which is nothing but gw03.activeverse.com. But when we run in cluster mode, all the Spark APIs will be executed on the worker nodes. Now, what are those worker nodes? It all depends upon the framework you are using as part of your cluster setup. In our cluster, which is a 10-node cluster, which is available via labs.itversity.com, the link will be provided to you as part of the description. If you are new to ITversity, you can sign up and you can practice the same way as the other students are practicing. And we will be supporting the same way I'm supporting as part of this demo. So here, once you sign up, you will get access to 10-node cluster. You can also view the cluster using Ambari. I'm logging into Ambari. So you will get your own username to log in. You will not be able to log in using admin. And you can go to hosts and you can see the hosts here. There are 5 worker nodes. You can also go to Yarn here and you can click on node managers. These are the worker nodes in our cluster, WN01 through WN05. There are 5 nodes like that. So when we actually run this in Yarn mode, the Spark APIs will be executed on these worker nodes. They will not be executed on the node where the Spark session is launched or Spark context is created. So now to demonstrate, I can exit from here. Instead of using just PySpark 2, I want to specify --master yarn. And also, just to avoid running into out of port issue, I am passing this additional property. You will understand once you sign up for the labs and once you get into the system, we will walk you through how to take care of this. Okay. Now, when I launch like this, if I use the same code where I want to read the file from home trying diamonds.csv, it will fail. The reason is the actual Spark API execution will be taken care on worker nodes, not on the node where we have created this Spark context, which is nothing but gw03.itvarsity.com. Okay, so if you want to get more details about which execution mode it is running and all, once the Spark context is created, you can always use this piece of code for IN spark.sparkcontext.getconf.getAll print of I, and you will get all the runtime properties which will control this session's runtime behavior. And if you scroll up, there is a property which will give us the UI. It is nothing but this one, and the value is this. So we can actually take this. Let me zoom out a bit here so that I get the URL without getting trimmed off. So in this case, it is nothing but this one. So we have to copy this, open another tab, paste it, and it will take us to a Spark job UI. You can click on execute us and you can see the details. You can do this even for local mode, and with local mode, you will be seeing only one executor, which is nothing but driver. As everything will be executed on the same server where the file is, you will be able to see the files in local mode. But when we run in cluster mode, the execution of Spark APIs will be on these nodes. We have 5 nodes. By default, it will create 2 executors on those worker nodes, and then it will actually process the data further depending upon the logic which we have developed to process that data. That being said, because the execution happens on this and the file is on gw03.itvarsity.com, if I use this piece of code which was working earlier, it will fail. So header equal to true, info schema equal to true, and then circular bracket and hit enter. So she was able to, the student who raised the issue was able to read the data when he or she used the terminal. And but when it comes to using Jupyter Notebook where we have provided instructions to use cluster mode, as the session is created in cluster mode, the file was not available for processing the way the same logic which was working earlier stopped working now. Okay, so you can see that it is throwing exception, does not exist. So now I can come out of this. Instead of using this terminal, I'll be creating a notebook. File, new notebook. We have 4 kernels: Python 3, PySpark 2, Spark Scala, Spark SQL. So in this case, I will be using PySpark 2 for this purpose. Okay, let me rename this. I will also provide this notebook for you. Local local files to data frames. Local files to Spark data frames. Let me name it this way. Okay. So once you create the notebook with PySpark to kernel, first thing you need to do is you have to import a class called as Spark Session, which is available as part of PySpark.sql package. Once you do that, you can actually create the Spark Session object by saying Spark equal to Spark Session dot builder dot. I will pass this config because I just want to use a random port instead of the static port so that everyone will get some port associated with the context that is being created. Otherwise, after 16 retries, it will fail. You will understand these things once you start going through my material. And I will provide the links for the material which you can leverage to practice Spark with Python. And also the link to LAF, the Slack channel, etc. as part of the description of this video. You can take it from there. So if you like this content and if it makes sense for you, please click on the like button. You can also share with your friends by clicking on share in the social networking platforms. If you want, you can subscribe to the channel as well and click on the notification button so that whenever I run these sessions, you get the information into your mailbox and you can join. You can also watch the pre-recorded videos because I will make these videos public. That being said, now I can say app name, local files. We should give a meaningful name to these two data frames. And then master, we want to use cluster mode. If I use local, it will work. But if we specify master yarn, it will run into the cluster mode and we will not be able to read the file the way it was working in the local mode. Okay, get or create, and then run this. So it will create an object by name Spark. The data type of that object is nothing but Spark session. It will just take a moment to create this. Until you see asterisk here, it is still bringing up that Spark context by creating this object. Once you see the number here, then you can actually start developing the logic using this notebook. So far we have imported this Spark session, and then we have created this Spark session object, which is nothing but Spark. Okay, now I can say spark.read.csv. You can also get the help by using question mark here, and you should be able to see the syntax. Okay, or you can also say help of spark.read.csv, a typical Python approach. Let me clear this output and let me use this API and let me provide the path as file colon slash 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 home training diamonds.csv. And let me assign it to a data frame DS and let us try to run it. You can see that it is failing. Let me also add a bit of additional arguments. So the first argument is nothing but header equal to true. And then info schema equal to true. Even with these things, it will fail. Typically when we directly use spark.read.csv, we use these additional properties. Now, how to read the local file into the data frame so that we can use this small data set to join with the bigger data sets which are already created as data frames. For that, we have to use regular Python libraries. So we need to read data from the driver program. So as part of the driver program, we have to develop additional logic. And then we have to hand over that the data which is loaded from the local file in the driver program into a data frame. For that, we have to follow a few steps. The first step is we have to read the data from local file system into a data structure. We can use pandas for that. Once you have pandas data frame, we can pass the data frame to spark.create data frame and it will hand over a data structure onto the worker nodes in the form of a Spark data frame. So let me walk you through the steps here. So we can delete this. We have to use pandas So I can say import pandas as PD. So this piece of code will be executed on worker node, sorry, not worker node, on the gateway node on which this Jupyter notebook is running, which is nothing but gw03.itbus.com. You can visualize it as the driver program in this picture. And driver program and the file are on the same server. And hence, we should be able to use this Python code, which will be running on the driver program itself. And we should be able to read the data. So in this case, I can say diamonds underscore PD equal to, as part of PD, to read the data into a data frame where the structure also will be there, we can say read underscore CSV. And we can specify the path. What is the path? Home training diamonds.csv. If you want to get the help for this read underscore CSV, again, you can say pd.read underscore CSV question mark or help of pd.read underscore CSV, and you should be able to see the details. Now you can run this. You can check the type of this variable by saying diamonds underscore pd. It is of type pandas core frame data frame. You can also visualize data by saying diamonds underscore pd. You can see the data. Now, this is a data frame which is created as part of the driver program. However, if I want to join this with some other Spark data frame, which is a bit bigger in size, then we have to convert this pandas data frame into Spark data frame. How to do that? For that, as part of Spark, there is an API called as create data frame. Okay, let me name it as diamonds underscore spark data frame. As pandas data frame already have the structure, we don't need to specify that header equal to true and info schema equal to true. We can directly pass this data frame and it will work without any issues. Okay. Now you can run this and then you can say type of diamonds underscore SD. It is of type pyspark.sql.dataframe.dataframe. You can print the schema using the dataframe APIs such as diamonds underscore fd dot print schema. You can also preview the data by saying diamonds dot fd dot show, underscore fd dot show. Okay, now if you want to join with other data frames, you can use the dataframe API called as join. If you want to get a count, you can say diamonds underscore fd dot count. If you want to filter, you can apply where all filter. You just need to have enough knowledge with respect to this Spark data frame. All that knowledge can be achieved for free as part of our Apache Spark 2 using Python 3 playlist. I'll be sharing those details as part of the description. You can start learning from there. And I will add this video also towards the end of that playlist so that I can share this information whenever someone asks with respect to this similar use case. And this is how I will be able to support you. I can impersonate login as you, and I can actually fix your code and save a lot of your time. Going forward, the learning experience will be using Jupyter notebooks. There are so many advantages. You will be able to learn very fast. You will be getting 10 node cluster access. I don't think anyone is providing such a cluster capacity anywhere in the world with that price. And we are also upgrading our cluster to CDH very soon. And we will most likely will not be changing the prices. You can leverage the cluster to practice the data science related stuff, Spark related stuff, etc. We'll be coming up with a lot of material with respect to data science, Spark, Kafka, all those things, and we'll be providing high quality support for you. I'll be building a team of support staff for that over a period of time, both volunteers as well as the employees of ITversity, so that your issues are resolved as fast as we can via Slack. All the details related to labs, Slack, and also the playlist will be provided as part of the description once the video streaming is completed. That being said, if you like this video, please click on the like button. Feel free to share with your friends and sign up for the labs if you are interested to learn on a multi-node cluster. And let's see how it goes as we learn together to get into the data engineering using all the key skills that are important as of today. Thank you. Bye.